This is Joey with Granatelli Motorsports. I walked by here the other day and was looking underneath the truck and couldn't figure out where the engine was. We were able to start a conversation, and I really want him to share his story. Would you mind telling everybody?
Yeah, so let's start with, this was a project that started 7 years ago. We originally started with an F100 Ford truck. We bought our shocks and we're like, shoot, this is way too big. They're not gonna fit. So we're just driving down the road and we're like, hey, what if we just buy a crashed Chevy truck? So we went to the junkyard, bought a crashed Chevy truck, started building the project, and then we ran into a little problems like any project does. So the shocks actually in the rear are 7 feet tall if they're fully extended, which is a foot above me, which is absolutely crazy. And then the shocks in the front stand 4 feet tall. So it has 36 inches of travel in the front. So this front tire will go 3 feet up and will go through three, when it's fully, if you put this car on the front of a forklift, the tire will actually drop 3 feet to the ground before the tires even come off the ground.
That's crazy.
So you can drive this thing over anything. A curb, no problem. K-rails, what is that? So this is like the ultimate, this is what we call a luxury pre-runner. So we just took the pre-runner, which is an awesome thing that a lot of people do. We just took it way overboard. So it runs 40 inch tires in the front, 40 inch tires
so
in the
massive.
Rear. It has a LS7 with a supercharger that's located right here in the middle of the cab. So a lot of pre-runners will have it in the front. We extended it back just because the arms and the tires are just so big.
That was the thing that I noticed when I walked by. I couldn't figure out, and I'll show you guys in a little bit. When I walked by, I couldn't figure out whether it had an engine or not.
A lot of people come up and they're like, is it a hybrid? Like, where's the motor? But no, we extended it back just so it has a lot more travel for off-roading use.
That's so cool.
I can tell you this truck will probably never see the dirt because we don't want to scratch it.
It's a show car.
It's a show pre-runner.
Why did you do it?
So we did it, well, originally when we were going to go with the Ford, the single cab Ford, was kind of like, hey, our budget is 30 grand. Let's just build a truck that we can go to the dunes or to the dirt and just destroy and not really care. And then when we moved over to this truck, we're like, okay, you know what? SEMA's right around the corner. We're like, let's just build something absolutely insane because we have an IndyCar background. So
okay. We
really wanted to take the luxury pre-runner way to the next level, and I think we kind of took it a little too far.
Well, now are you going to build another one that you can actually
use
for play?
Yes, we are actually going to build another one. Hopefully it doesn't take 7 years to build because I'll be too old to drive it and it'll hurt my back.
Yeah, like me. I don't know. You were saying that you can desert dunes and
yes, desert
sounds
dunes.
Fun.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun, but stuff breaks and it's very expensive.
Yeah, that was one reason with my Camaro. My dad wanted to do like a show drag car. He wanted to tub it and everything, and I'm like,
yeah, mini tub, yeah.
I don't know if I want to do that because I want to actually drive it.
Yeah, no, I understand.
So if you're going to do another one.
Yeah, we're going to build another one that's just more, I would say, just trophy truck. So it'll have no luxury, no suede headliner, no suede seats, no AC, no navigation system with Bluetooth. No flashy lights everywhere. Probably a vinyl, not a expensive paint job on it.
So that if you take it out,
yeah,
you're
when
not
I take it
like
out, we
crying.
Can use it, abuse it, and if the fenders blow off, it's hey, fender blew off.
So with your business, what do you guys specialize?
We really specialize in ignition coils, ignition wires, and exhaust components. So on this vehicle, it is running every product we make. So it has our full oval exhaust tubing. 3-inch tubing, mandrel bended. So it really gives you the ground clearance. Even though you really don't need ground clearance in a truck like this, we did it just to show it off. This car is extremely quiet. When people were coming in, they're like, what is it? Is it a hybrid? Is that a, because a lot of electric cars now are running speakers for exhausts.
I think I heard that on one
of
the
you
other
heard
cars.
Them down, yeah, a couple of cars over there, they're running speakers for exhausts. They're like, that thing should be like extremely loud, obnoxious, but we wanted to keep it low key because when we do drive it every day on the road, we don't want it to be like, oh, look at that truck. And then the cops just look at you like, hey, that doesn't look right.
Well, they're probably gonna stop you because it's cool.
Yes, I know they're gonna stop us because it's cool, but we still want it to be too red thumbed.
That's awesome. Do you mind giving us a tour?
Yeah, let's take a look around the truck.
So since we can't take the hood off,
yeah,
we're going
it's
underneath.
A little hard to take the roof off, we actually located the motor 3 feet back from its original location. So where the front of the motor would be right here, we pushed it back. So the throttle body, which is probably hard to see, is way up here, which it should be right here. So we just did that for, we're running shocks that are a little extraordinary or a little extreme for everyday road use. But you can see everything here, solid J-arms, which is a very off-road design. Super, everything we do is super beefy because we didn't want this truck to break at all. So radiator cooling, it runs 6 fans in the back, which we'll take a look at that a little bit later. And then we have rock lights just to kind of show the glamorous. So if you turn the cameras right around to right here, it has rock lights. So it kind of gives it, when you're in the middle of the desert and you can't see, instead of having lights, having your flashlight, and like, oh, hold it here, hold it there, we have rock lights.
Oh, I didn't even realize that would be a thing. That's cool.
Yeah, it's super cool. So let's take a look inside the vehicle now. So what's great about our truck is all the body line still fits true. So it closes just like a passenger car, right? Which a lot of designers, when they're building a big truck like this, when you cut out the floor, it starts to twist the car because it loses all its strength. But with ours, we actually made it so the body line is still true to itself. So let's open the door. It's still, a lot of pre-runners will actually weld this door shut so it doesn't open. But since this is our luxury pre-runner and we want this to win Battle of the Builders, which is a huge honor if we do, that's why we did it. So it has full suede leather Alcantara, has shock seats, so when you're actually driving it off-road, the seat has its own little shock inside.
Oh, no way. Like the seats themselves?
Yeah, the seat has a spring inside of it, so it's super
cool.
Duper cushy. When we designed it, we wanted it to have 2 briefcases, so it could be an everyday. So you can put your purse, your handbag, your kind of like a small carry-on item behind you. So if we just jump in here, right? We have dome lights, right? So it's fully lit, so if we, I don't know. It doesn't worry about that. So Holley dashboard, full navigation system. You can see over here, big.
Let's see if I can sneak in around the corner.
A big 12-inch screen right here. So on a normal pre-runner, you don't need the speedometer. You don't need RPM because you're driving so fast through the desert.
Oh, here, you don't have time. On the other side. See if I can sit in while holding the camera.
Yeah.
Oi. Oh, let's see. Trying it one-handed. Okay. Oh, this is cool. And yes, I have my tutu on. So what were you? You were showing the dash?
Okay, so we're showing, yeah. So everything, when you are driving a pre-runner truck, everything is on the passenger side because he's going to tell you through the intercom what's going on, if you're having any problems, the oil temperatures, right? Because nobody wants a car to overheat or lose oil because that'd be bad, break it. So everything is in the center console. So if I wanted to do turn signals, ignition, headlights, I don't want to blind the guy in front of me because that would be kind of rude. Work lights. So the work lights, which we'll take a look again, are white lights instead of having the blue lights underneath.
Mm-hmm.
But pretty much we give every creature comfort of having a normal everyday truck. Just took it to the extreme.
That's awesome.
Little pre-runner system.
I would probably do that all day just because
it's
clicks.
Super fun.
That's
but yeah.
Awesome.
So you're not, when you walk around the show, you're going to see not many race cars or luxury cars have Bluetooth navigation in a truck that does the capability of this. Another cool feature is we have a refrigerator in the back, which right now it's at -3. But you can feel it's ice cold.
Oh, wow,
in there.
It's huge.
Yeah, it's humongous.
When you build your second one, are you going to put a fridge in that one too?
Probably not, because we'll probably put 3 seats in it just so somebody else can have fun too.
Got it.
It has a full sound system, which is kind of nice.
That's awesome. Cool. You wanted to show us the lights on the outside?
If you come over here, you can see underneath, we just changed the lights from blue to white.
Oh, with the button that you pushed?
Yeah, with the button I pushed. So, what we can do for you is, when we built the truck, everything is one man unless the hood, because the hood is just so massive. So let me put this down. You can see it just literally lifts.
Oh, they might not be able to hear you because you put the sound thing down.
We're going to show off the big 7-foot shock. So you can see it's fully compressed in here right now. It's absolutely massive. Two Optima batteries, because with all these lights, it does take a lot of power. So 212 volts.
Those are the ones that you said that these would be.
Yeah,
what?
So these things, if you took this out, the thing would be 7 feet tall. The shocks would be 7 feet tall.
How did
yeah.
you get them in there then? Do they compress them when you?
Yes,
get them?
They do compress them. So what we had to do is we had to get a forklift and we had to lift up the back of the truck, and then you literally just push them down where they need to go.
Oh my gosh, that's crazy.
Another great thing is this thing has a 120-gallon gas tank. So with gas prices right now, it's well over $1,000, which is pay to play. So,
what would the gas mileage be on this?
Mileage on this would actually not be that bad. Before we had this motor in the truck, I had it in a 2010 Camaro, and on the highway, I was averaging 27 miles per gallon. So with a heavy truck like this, we'll probably see 10 to 15. Which is not bad when you compare it to a new Escalade is getting the same gas mileage but doesn't have all the cool stuff like this on it. I would rather drive this every day than an Escalade, but I don't want to pay for the gas.
Yeah, that's true. And then you got like the full-size tire in the
back.
So
yeah, so we have two full-size 40-inch tires in the back too. So if you want to come around here, I'm going to pull this back for you.
Oh, you got two.
Yeah, we got two. And we have a backup camera.
Ah, that I think that would be, like, because how else would you be able to see?
Exactly. Well, you can't see down. You can kind of see over the tires, but let's just say you were off-roading and you did get in a sticky situation. You want to make sure that you're not going to run over a rock or go off a cliff, because
yeah,
be bad
no
news
cliffs,
there.
Especially with navigation nowadays.
Exactly.
It's like rerouting and it takes
rerouting.
You off a cliff.
Please make a legal U-turn when possible.
That's awesome.
But I'm so glad you came by. We got confirmation that we are making it to the next round of Battle of the Builders, so we
Yay.
Did make top 10 in our division. So we'll just see where it goes from there.
Thank you so much for giving me the
it's
tour.
It's no problem. Thank you for stopping by. It was kind of funny watching you, like, you're like getting lower and lower and lower. Like, where's the motor?
Well, so him and his dad were both sitting in the truck as I'm walking by, and they're like, what is this weirdo trying
like, what is she looking at? Like, we understand she wanted to see the truck. But just like the curiosity of like what am I looking at? Like, I understand your channel is it's KISS, keep it simple, stupid. So, which is good, right? Because it simplifies everything, where you're trying to teach everybody like, hey, you're not as knowledgeable as I am, but there's stuff that you do that you know more than me. So I've watched a lot of your videos last night. I literally went on your channel, click, 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 click. I went through your Instagram, which is very funny. So
thank
I
you.
Love it. I love it. I love
just,
it. I love it.
You know, it was an excuse today because
exactly.
it's Halloween to
hey,
wear my
tutu.
It's
Halloween. You got to do what you got to do. But yeah, if you want to follow us back up, you can follow us at GranatelliMotorsports.com.
Okay.
We're building another car on there called Project S-Fox. Originally, it's called Project Shit Fox.
That's
because
funny.
It was a complete dump. It was a vehicle, they said, that was never crashed. Clean title. We looked at it. The VIN number said it had a clean title. We took the car apart and it looked like somebody ran it over with a train.
Oh,
so
man.
It drove straight. So it drove fine. It looked fine, but it's a project we're working on. That will be done for next season or next SEMA show. So it will be here. So if you want to stop by next year,
the goal is to be able to come back next year.
You will be here next year. I know it. But yeah, we'll take a video of that, and that one will be even more extreme than this car.
So I'm excited.
Yeah.
Well, like, where will you put the engine now? Like, on the roof?
Yeah. That's 2 years from now. We're going to put a rear engine. But,
yeah, you guys are going to have to stay tuned
exactly.
for that. And you said, so I followed you on Instagram, but would you mind telling them how they could follow you
on Instagram? Yeah, so if you go to Instagram, it's GranatelliMotorsports.com. We'll just probably put it below.
Yeah, he'll send me this stuff, and I'll put it in the
caption.
Just
because it's really long.
Yeah.
And then I'll also tag you in the new project we're working on, so you can put that also in the video. It's
awesome.
It's a 91 Fox Body Mustang. It's going to have an LS swap in it, and the suspension on that is going to be pretty extreme. It's going to have aerodynamics to the moon. It's going to be pretty wicked.
That's awesome. All right, you guys. Thank you. Go ahead and follow Joey and his dad, Big Joe, and follow their next project.
Yeah, sounds good.
So much.
Thank you.